The Uganda Wildlife Authority and the National Environment Management Authority estimates that 70% of the oil Albertine graben is in the protected area of national parks and game reserves. It is the most important tourist destination in Uganda. It is estimated that the tourism sector contributes to over $800 million, approximately 2 trillion Uganda shillings, to the country's economy annually. But environmental experts are warning that oil exploration in Albertine graben could adversely affect the sector if companies do not adopt environmentally friendly technologies to drill the oil.
And once animals move from one area to another, or some of them impacted by the activities like heat or dust or some, they will definitely move and that will have an impact. That means you must adjust to new tourism areas or divert and take away some of those tourism activities to another area. And the concern is very true that if you do not manage tourism well, you could as well lose those gains which you are making in foreign exchange earnings, besides the normal employment, livelihood projects and community improvement, yes.
They told a Parliamentary Committee on Natural Resources this morning that oil drilling is a sensitive activity to wildlife, resulting from vibrations especially to elephants. The vibration also interferes with animal breeding patterns like cobra-breaking grounds, animal migration routes, habitats, and the killing of wildlife resulting from hydrocarbon compounds and chemicals used during oil drilling. Uganda Wildlife Authority experts say government must force oil companies to use environmentally friendly technologies to allow coexistence of both oil activities and the wildlife. For instance, Murchison Falls National Park, one of the largest, is located in the protected area with 21 oil wells. Other areas include Renzori Mountains, Bwindi Impenetrable National Park, Queen Elizabeth National Park, Kibale National Park, and Semiriki, among others, are all in the Albertine graben.
We have fears that when the actual production starts, we might lose some of the animals. We need to retain these hippos, the elephants, the buffaloes.
Yes, if we don't handle the operations properly, for sure, Murchison Falls will not be there tomorrow.
Stand your ground, let us know, we will support you.
We shall always do that.
Yes, don't die under the pressure of doing wrong things.
Uganda Wildlife Authority needs 4 billion shillings, while NEMA needs 8 billion shillings to oversee the activities of oil exploration and production. Jingo Francis, NTV, Parliament.